My friends, welcome to the supply chain lecture. I will explain more on supply chain. Let's see some basic definitions of supply chain. Supply chain management is the chain of multiple activities that includes planning, controlling and executing a physical flow of the product from acquiring raw material, then processing raw material for manufacturing or production and then its distribution to the final customer. Supply chain must do all this product flow management in the most streamlined and possible cost-effective way. Simply, we can say that supply chain management is an integrated planning and execution of activities or processes which are required to optimize the flow of materials, information, and financial capital. Supply chain broadly includes key activities like demand planning, sourcing, production, inventory management, storage, transportation or logistics. Also, it includes returning excess or defective products. Those supply chain activities in some or other way makes flow of information and finance. Supply chain management is a complex process and network that relies on each partner in the chain, like from suppliers to manufacturers and other partners, to run it smoothly. Due to a complex and dependency nature, effective supply chain management strongly requires change management, collaboration and alignment, risk planning and control, and seamless communication between all the partners. Let's see typical supply chain network on high level. As per some of the definitions, supply chain starts with acquiring raw material, hence supply chain usually starts with suppliers. Supplier is an organization or business partner that provides something needed, such as a product or service. Usually supplier provides raw materials and services in general definition of supply chain management. The next partner in supply chain is the manufacturer. Manufacturer is usually an organization or business partner that makes final goods for sale. It is also referred as finished goods. Next partner in the chain is distributor. Usually distributor is an organization or business partner who supplies goods to retailers where sales of finished goods is supposed to happen. Next partner in our chain is the retailer or wholesaler. Usually retailers are business partners that sells goods to the public or end customer in relatively small quantities for use or consumption rather than for resale. And the main component of supply chain is the shopper or end customer who needs the finished good that is manufactured by manufacturer. In the entire process, if you will see, there is forward movement of product and reverse movement of the finance and information. Let's see how information moves. Backward, information like how many number of products, features, qualities are being bought or purchased by end customer goes to retailers. Then retailers use this information to make sure stocking of right material has to happen for increasing revenue and reduced lead times to customers. The information again goes back to distributors, and that makes distributors to plan storage, containers, pallets and different distribution methods. The information also flows back from retailers to manufacturers, like what products are preferred by retailers to stock and how much. This information makes sure to plan in advance for manufacturers and also making their suppliers ready with raw materials that is required. Thus, information from the end customer goes in a different set of meaning across each supply chain partner. Thus, supply chain is following the cycle of plan, source, make, deliver and return. In this cycle, plan means it is important to have a plan for managing all the resources that are needed to meet customer demand, products or services. Source means choosing reliable suppliers to deliver quality goods and services required for making products. Make means companies manufacture their products or services, includes scheduling the activities necessary for product testing, packaging and preparing for delivery. Deliver means the set of processes that plans for and controls the efficient and effective transportation and storage or supplies from suppliers to customers. And return means companies must create a network for receiving defective and excess products to support customers having problems with delivered products.